Okay, we are live.
Hey guys, it's David and Christy. Friday at the farm.
Friday's at the farm.
Come on, girl.
And so here we are. So the question we threw out there today is, how great is your Dane? And we wanted to introduce you to another one of our animals. Charlie Chicken's doing great.
Yeah.
But here we go.
Charlie Chicken might be on the dinner table
yeah.
next Friday. I don't know. He's making too much noise at like way too early.
Like 4 o'clock in the morning. He's got his nights and mornings mixed up, I think. But here we go.
But this girl right here, come on now.
Yeah.
This is Stone. Isn't she gorgeous?
Oh.
Hey,
Stone.
Say hi.
Hey, say
Stone.
Hi. Can you say hi? Yeah. You're my girl. Okay.
Oh, so you guys, I just want to share briefly. Stone came to us. She was emaciated. She was malnourished. She was so skinny. She was flea ridden. And a good friend of mine knew that it has been one of my dreams for so long to have a Great Dane. And I specifically dreamt of having a Harlequin. And look at her. Look at her. She's just absolutely
gorgeous. Hang on. Let me see if I can't get back here.
Look at this girl. Say hi, Stone. She's a good girl. But you know what? We decided to take this Dane on. We decided to rescue her and help nourish her back to health. And she's just precious.
Yes, she is. And she is. And I won't lie. This Great Danes are my favorite breed simply because they are lovers
yeah.
and they think they're big lap dogs. So people get afraid of them because they're so big, but they are just, they're the greatest. They're just great. We
yeah,
love them.
She eats a lot, that's for sure.
But it was a story. We got a call, like Christy said, we got a call from a friend. And they had found this dog, and she looked horrible. The bottoms of her paws were burned from the hot black top, and it has just been a blast to have her.
I don't know if you guys can see this, but we are being covered right now with gnats.
Yeah.
It is November. It is almost 80 degrees in South Georgia, and the gnats are out in full force. And they're nasty.
I sprayed bug spray on before we filmed. So so the question is, how great is your Dane? How great is your Dane?
My Dane is great. She's way better now.
So, Christy, how do we want to tie that in today just in what we're talking about?
Well, first of all, I just wanted to let you guys know, you know, each Friday we're going to be talking about people that we have met that have changed our lives. And today we wanted to introduce you just to a lady that has done over 40 years of research on the body, on metabolism, how it affects the brain. And I want you to go and look her book up. David's got the book.
I've got the book. Again, you're going to see it backwards.
It's called Silent Takeover. How to Overcome Emotional, Mental, and Addictive Disorders. Jacqueline Shepherd, she is originally from Georgia. She now lives in Missouri. But she has quickly become a mentor of ours in many ways. But I want to encourage you to go get that book. If you're dealing with a mental, an emotional, or addictive disorder, which, how many, what's the percentage?
Well, I was just reading an article in the USA Today that said 1 in 7 Americans are going to struggle with addiction of some sort. 1 in 7. So first of all, if you're struggling with that in whatever form it is, you're not alone.
That's right.
Second of all, it's not hopeless. There are ways out. And I want to, Christy, can you hold this camera real quick?
Absolutely.
I just want to read a quick portion. And
the sun is too bright.
Yeah, the sun is bright, but I got to get my glasses on. In chapter one, she says, we habitually attribute behavior to choice. And while there is a great truth in choice, it is very difficult to ascribe choice to all circumstances, because sometimes we find ourselves in circumstances that we didn't choose that. We didn't have much of a say-so in that, but we find ourselves in that situation. And so what I found is, as we've gotten to know Jackie and as I've read this book, there are things that we can do across the board that can help us walk out of situations that we feel
yeah.
really stuck in. Hey, we're born to be Great Danes, but sometimes we don't feel so great. This dog is absolutely gorgeous, majestic, regal. That was the thing that with Danes that I fell in love with years ago. And we're born great. And sometimes we forget that.
Yeah. And you know, sometimes it's what we choose. It's sometimes what others choose for us. But we just want to encourage you today, especially as we're going into the holidays.
Yeah.
You're going to be around people, family. You're going to be around people that you don't really get to see throughout the year. It may invoke some emotion in you that you've not had to deal with. I just want to encourage you to walk in freedom and in healing, and just understand, you know, that you got to just sometimes take a deep breath.
Yeah, and the other side of that, not, you know, yes, sometimes you find yourself around people that hurt you, but then others will find themselves alone. And there's the depression that comes with just being alone and not around anybody.
That's right.
And I think we would encourage you, even, I was reading something, the intake of calories over the next 2 months between Thanksgiving and Christmas is insane. People eat stuff that they don't normally eat. They drink more. And we just want to encourage you, even moving in that self-discipline, realize that what everything affects who we are spiritually, relationships, food, it all has a play into who we are. So just be aware of that as we're moving into this season.
Yeah.
And kind of, if we can just, I know I, let me just say this. I have to.
Yeah. We all have to be careful of that.
Yeah. So it's great being with you guys. And man, I just, happy holidays. We'll be with us next week again, Fridays at the farm.
Yeah, and we look forward to introducing you to more of our incredible friends, more of our farm animals, and we look forward to seeing you next Friday.
Yeah, so Fridays at the Farm, Healthy, Happy Human. Check us out on Facebook, but find Jacqueline Shepherd's book, Silent Takeover.
Absolutely.
All right, we'll
see
talk to you guys
later. Bye.